All right, the Broken Arrow Tigers are close to where they want to be. You see, they want to be able to beat Jinx and Union on an annual basis so they can contend for that 6A title. Now, I wouldn't call them an up-and-coming type team. Instead, you'll probably still give that label to the Sand Springs Sandites. An injury to quarterback Johnny Deaton has put a wrinkle in their plans for this year, but a win tonight would really help get them back on track. Broken Arrow at Sand Springs. The Sandites have made a lot of noise over the last couple of years, so they're going to continue to make some noise, pick it up on a third down play. Brent Bollinger trying to make something happen. He scrambles. You better tuck that football, son. About 9.5 yards. I'm sure the coach is going to be telling him that when he gets to the sidelines. Nice play, but they got to punt that bad boy anyway. Later in the first, Broken Arrow's ball, Archie Bradley pitches the ball to Stephen Hopper, who is now healthy, and it shows. A couple of nice cuts. 67 yards later, he's gone for the touchdown. 7-0 at that point. Last check we had in this one, Broken Arrow went away with the win, 49-21. Blackwell and Berryhill. Berryhill already up 28-0 when we show up. And this is just in the second quarter. Berryhill hands the ball to Adam Dolan. He goes left and cuts up the middle, cuts back left again. Almost gets tripped up, but finds his way into the end zone, even with that little bit of a push right there for the touchdown. Fans are excited, and they have more to be screaming about a little bit later. Still in the second, it worked just a minute ago. That she was really excited about being on TV. Why not give it to Dolan again? This time he goes right up the middle and kind of dives slash falls into the end zone. Berryhill wins this one, going away 40-12. All right, here's some scores for you. Broken Bow on top of Wagner, 10-7, the final in their game. Jay beats Collinsville, 17-0 is the final there for the Jay Bulldogs. Hilldale loses to Fort Gibson, 26-22. Webster losing to Muldrow, 21-12 in the third quarter's last check we had. Ulaga beats Grove, 35-21, the final in that one. And Catoosa, 45-7 on top of Bonita in the fourth. All right, we made a trip today all the way down to Salina to watch this big battle between Commerce and Salina. Both teams undefeated in district play. Both teams undefeated, and Commerce gets on the board first. Bryson Sullivan takes that 19 yards for the touchdown, makes it 14-0 at that point, Commerce. But Darren Pettit, who's had a great year so far, scrambles, makes about 20 yards on that run, gets it all the way down to the 13-yard line. A couple of plays later, Dylan Mitchell and Paul Harvey hook up for the touchdown, makes it 14-8. Commerce on top, but final in this one, 22-14, Salina wins. I'll tell you why that's important here in just a couple of minutes. All right, some more scores for you. Cash Hall on top of Perkins, 49-19 in the fourth quarter. Inola losing to Claremore Sequoia, 68-20. That's a lot of points to score. 31-19 was the last check we had in the Metro Christian game in the third, but that bad boy's got to be over by now. Final victory, Christian loses to Dewey, 62-7. That's very lopsided. Tahlequah Sequoia on top of Westville, 28-6. And Bayan beating Kansas, 17-0 in the third. All right, time for our final break. When we come back, I'll show you my pick for play of the night. Plus, all right, for this week's Ford Award nomination, we hit the road, and I managed to get a T-shirt out of the deal. Here's what it says. Take what you can, give nothing back. Coming up, I'm going to tell you who's this week's Ford Award nominee and where I got this T-shirt.